struggling to get organised at work? By the end of this video, you'll know how to use Microsoft ToDo with getting things done and power methodologies to supercharge your productivity. I've got new videos on Microsoft Teams and Microsoft 365 coming out every Tuesday, so hit the subscribe button and the bell icon to get notified when I release a new video. I'm Gavin Jones, a former transformation manager for a Fortune 500 company. I now help organizations of any size with modern workplace transformations. If you're interested in working together, then stick around until the end of the video to find out more. Okay, so we're gonna go through my to-do and how I structure it with Getting Things Done and Power. So Getting Things Done is a book by David Allen, which has a lot of avid fans that are really, really passionate about making his methodology work exactly how he said it. I am not one of those people, but this works for me and it might work for you as well. So if you've not read Getting Things Done by David Allen, the building blocks of that are to get stuff out of your head into one place, and then once you've got it there, categorize it and then decide what you're going to work on when, which is the general gist of doing any sort of task management. But the four things he says you need are probably the biggest to me is inbox, a someday maybe list, a tickler list, which is stuff that you can't start yet, and some way of tracking things that you're waiting on other people to do. So in to do, there's a few different ways we can categorize things. So one is by a list, one is by a group, and the other, which is probably not that well used, is hashtags, because then hashtags help you search and you can search and basically split your list however then you want to do. So for me, I use Getting Things Done, and that's why I've got a group called Getting Things Done, because these things are then not used anywhere else apart from just to help get things done. Inbox is where I put anything that I've ever thought of or anything that I need to do. So if you watched my last video on Outlook and to do, you can watch that here. Helps get everything out of your email inbox into then a task inbox. But your task inbox has got everything from your email, which is things other people want you to do, everything from your head, everything from the goals that you want to do in your job or in your life, anything from that you've taken down in notes, all gets put into your task inbox once a week, at least in that weekly review. And then once you've got it in your inbox, then you need to go through and decide, is it something that you want to do right now? If it's not, you just drag it out into someday maybe. If it is something you want to do, you then need to clarify what that action is. So you should rewrite the title, presumably, if you just added it in very quickly, and turn that into an action or sub-actions and decide the very next action that you need to take to move that project forwards if it is a multi-step project. So how I like to do that is to have folders for inbox, someday maybe, and tickler, and then use hashtags for everything else that David Allen says that you need in his book, Getting Things Done, such as a hashtag for waiting on, because I like to leave the task that I'm waiting on somebody in the relevant list. So I don't want a separate list for waiting on, because then they'll get merged together. That's just my preference. You could have a completely separate list for waiting on, and then you've got one list that you know you can't progress because everyone else is waiting for it. But I'll show you why I don't do that in a second. If you've got subtasks as part of a bigger project and you want to just waiting on one element of that, you can just add the hashtag in there, and you know that entire task is then stuck because you're waiting on someone else. That'll still show up in the search when we go and have a look at that. Everything else that he says that you might want to do, so splitting the tasks by the amount of energy that's needed, the amount of time that's needed, the context, is it shopping list, you need to be in the shop to actually do it, or you need to be online to do it, or it's a call or a meeting, and a hashtag for people. So I often run into someone and you think, oh, there's loads of stuff I need to talk to you about, and then if you've tag them in all the tasks that you've got to do that you might need help with, or you might be waiting for stuff off you even, then you've got one little search and then you can look at everything to do with that one person in one place. So for example, if I took this one task that I thought of today, which is create a custom Calendly message to welcome people that have booked a call with me, a bit better than the standard one. If you're interested in that, then book a call using the link in the description below if you're interested in working with me. It's already quite a good action, probably got no subtasks, but what I might do is then put some hashtags to help me decide when I want to do that. So I can put some hashtags like I need to be on my Mac to do that. I put some rough timing in, so actually that's quite a quick one. So I'm gonna do hashtag 15 minutes. It's not relating to anybody and it's not related to any project. So I think I'm okay with using the hashtags like that. I can put in whether it's high or low energy, and that's quite a low energy one. So it's one all the low energy ones I might want to do in the afternoon and use high energy in the morning if it's quite an in-depth and needs a lot of thinking, but this one probably won't. And then you can see it's turned all the hashtags blue there and underlined them. So wherever there's a hashtag there, if I click on it, it'll jump me into all of the 15 minute tasks that I could do. On the Mac version of ToDo, it does keep showing you completed tasks. You need to turn it off every time we do a search, which is relatively annoying. The PC app doesn't do that. So here you can see, I click on 15 minutes and it's got 15 minutes in the search. That's showing me all of the tasks that I could possibly do in 15 minutes. If I've just got 15 minutes in between meetings, or that meeting's finished early and I've got 15 minutes to the next meeting, I can then quickly do a quick search and see all of the things that I reckon are going to take 15 minutes and just bash out a few quick tasks rather than just languishing and going back into email and blah, blah, blah. I'm actually getting things done that I already know I need to do. So I'm curious, what task management software were you using before Microsoft ToDo? Let me know in the comments below what you thought about each. So similarly, if I needed to do a 15 minute and a low task, once I've got all my hashtags tagged, I can then do 15 minutes and low and then get a list of those. Usually 15 minutes a low task anyway, so it's not filtered my list anymore, but you can have a combination of hashtags in search, and that's where you can split the list any way that you want then. So you could get away just with hashtags and keep everything in tasks, which is your main list. I like to split everything out into inbox and then use my task list for more personal tasks and have other lists to split down the areas and projects that I'm working on at any one time. And that is using the PARA structure, which is P-A-R-A, which is designed and innovated by Forte Labs. I think I'll stick one of their blog posts in the description below, so have a look at that for a bit more detail. But that's basically saying your entire life is either a project, an area, a resource, or an archive, and you should have all of your digital assets to help you do that in that order. So if it's something that's going to end, it's a project. If it's something that's an area that you want to keep going, that's probably, you know, some aspects of your main job. If it's a resource, it's just something you want to keep around to refer to. And archive is just anything that you don't need out of everything else. And so I use the same file structure, the same structure in OneNote, and the same structure in ToDo to help all of the mental clutter. So in every one of those apps, I've got areas, projects, and archive. And in ToDo, I've got an extra one, which is to do with YouTube videos, where I've got a miniature sort of Kanban board where I come up with ideas and then drag that task in between these lists, similar to if you had Asana or a planner board, but just to keep it into my own personal view. So it doesn't look like cards, but the same gist in terms of how it works. So for areas, it's my YouTube video and Me Time Business, money, networking, the Me Time app on the iOS App Store, and some hobby, slight hobby, doing DJing and music. Those are all the areas I want to keep track of. And so rather than keeping my list just in hashtags and just in this getting things done buckets, I would then drag that into wherever it was relevant. So in this one, it might be my Me Time list, and just drag that in there. And so once you've got everything out of your Outlook inbox into here, along with everything else you might want to do, I would then clear up my getting things done inbox and schedule it into the appropriate list where it'll live until I then complete it. So that helps reduce mental clutter. It helps with batching. So if you're doing one thing, you can just go into one list and see all the things you need to do and work through those in one lump. The hashtags help you split your list by energy or context or whatever. If you're waiting for something, and I couldn't do this, create a custom Teams meeting link, I would then go on and put a hashtag WO, which is what I do to say I'm waiting on stuff, and then that would then live in the list that I'm waiting on that for. Again, if we had subtasks there, so maybe I should speak to Dave first and then create the link, and I've not spoken to Dave yet, I'm waiting for him to phone me back, I can then update that with waiting on Dave to phone back. And then although there's not a waiting on there, there's no hashtag right there, and again in the Mac app that doesn't get underlined if it's a subtask, but it does still work in search. If I then search for waiting on, so all the things that I'm waiting on, the top one there you see Dave to phone back, and it's a subtask that it's searching for in that list. If you can't start it yet, then I would go put it into tickler, so then that gets everything out of my other lists and into one place where I know that I can't actually do that task yet. I don't want to keep going into do stuff on me time and then finding out that go keep going down the list and it's like, oh yeah, I can't start that one, can't start that one, because there is no great way of adding a start date in ToDo. And due dates I would keep as completely sacred, so no point putting a date that you think you want to do it by, because then if it goes overdue you've then got another task to just keep moving it into a place where you think you're going to do it. Much better to keep the due date if there's no actual physical hard due date, if you're not going to get fired for missing that due date or something's bad is not going to happen, like you've missed paying your tax by that date, then I would always use remind me and use that to keep flagging stuff up that you might want to do or when you want to do it. And then what I actually do, which David Allen says do not do, is then go and schedule those tasks on my calendar in terms of when I want to do them, because then that blocks out time. I know I need to do that task and stops other people putting meetings over the top of it, and it's easier then to decline because they'll have already got stuff in there that I know I need to do, rather than taking your meeting. Also, quick rule of thumb is to do proactive stuff in the morning, so stuff that you already know you need to do from your task list in the morning, which is likely to be more in-depth stuff, and do reactive things in the afternoon, like take meetings, do low energy things, do quick tasks in the afternoon, so managing your energy to get the most done out of your task list at any one time. So we've just seen that Microsoft ToDo is great for personal productivity, but if you want to change the productivity of your entire organization, then it might be worth scheduling a call to find out about how we can help with a complete digital transformation. Book a call at a time suitable for you using the link in the description below. So check out these videos next. Remember to give the video a like, subscribe, and if you really like the video, consider supporting the channel by buying me a beer using a link in the description below. It really does help support the channel. But thanks for watching so far, and we'll see you in the next video.